August 1st, 1914. After the assassination of Prince Franz Ferdinand of the Austro-Hungarian Empire, the German Empire declares war on Russia. Because of established alliances, France is preparing for conflict. A few hours after the announcement of the general mobilization, German civilians living in France are asked to leave the country. Karl is one of them.
Calme-moi le bignou.
Allez, allez.
My dear Marie, we are on our way to Paris. The atmosphere here is strangely cheerful. I hope that the harvest goes well. Rely on our neighbors for help. They've always been gracious and charitable people. I'll write again as soon as I get my assignment. Please kiss my little grandson for me.
at the train depot in Paris, trying to reach his regiment at Platform 21, Emile would meet the man he would soon fight alongside. The man who would come to be his truest friend.
Allez, monsieur le binard.
Dis-moi, elle va baptiser. Arrêtez-moi, Blesaille.
Attends-le, fille de grand.
Ouais, petite crampage.
August 21st, 1914, Emil's regiment was sent to fight against the 71st German Division led by Baron von Dorf. The general cheer of the first hours dissipated into the fear of first combat.
Victory!
Freddie, originally from America, enlisted voluntarily in the French forces at the start of the war. Behind his bravery hid a man already devastated by the war's effects. A man with one sole obsession: punish those who had destroyed his life. It was at the Battle of the Marne that Freddie finally picked up the trail of the regiment commanded by Baron von Dorf. Thanks to support from British forces, the German plan failed. The front line moved back to the north, and with the arrival of winter, froze. Soldiers holed up amid a vast labyrinth of trenches and tunnels that would become the indelible image of the Great War. Karl's regiment retreated to the outskirts of Neuchâtel, the same camp where Emile was being held prisoner.
Schlussfort